بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. Inshallah, we continue with our booklet, الدليل العلمي, by Sheikh Abdul Aziz Al-Sathan, حفظه الله. And we have one of the segments that is short for tonight, which is segment number 7, talking about الملائكة. الملائكة عالم غيبي لا يحصي عددهم إلا الله تعالى. مخلوقون من نور لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. He's saying that the angels are unseen world. No one can number them other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this let us know that the huge number of Allah's creation, especially the angels, that they saw so many that no one can know their number other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ghaibi, that means unseen, that you could not see with your eyes, neither you can touch with your hand. So the only thing that involved here is the belief. Not seeing, not touching, not hearing, only that Allah said the angels there, that He created the angels, so we believe. He said, مخلوقون من نور, Allah had created them from lights. And also, by hearing this statement, our mind doesn't go to the light that may in front of the camera or the flashlight or the light in your car. All this called lights and different types of lights. But also the light that Allah is talking about, no one know what it is exactly other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He had created them from light. They never disobey Allah. Never disobey Allah, and they do what Allah commands them. The second part of the chapter, he said, من أسمائهم, among their names, جبريل وإسرافيل وميكائيل. Of course, that there are more angels that we got their names in Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So those whom Allah had named them, we believe in them by their names, and those who we don't know their names, we still believe in them. So he said, among them is Jibril, and he is the best because he doing the best and carries the most beautiful job, carrying the words of Allah and the message of Allah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to whom Allah will select among the human being to be a prophet or a messenger. We know about Israfil, which Israfil in charge of the trumpet, and he blowing it, everybody is dead. He blew in it for the second time, everybody will get out of their graves. فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. Mikael, which Allah put him in charge of the rain. And like I said, there is Ridwan, which is a guard of Jannah, the gate of Jannah, the gates of Jannah. And Malik, okay, which is in charge of the gates of hellfire, and other angels that we don't know their names, but we believe in all of them. He said, من أعمالهم, among their duties, the تكليف that Allah orders him to do كتابة الحسنات والسيئات recording the deeds of the human being. Every human being ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد. There is no uttering that any single human being utter except that there is a رقيب and عتيد. Two angels, one on the right and one on the left. The one on the right, he will write whatever good that he's saying, and the one on the left, they will record whatever evil or sin that he may say. Also among their jobs, قبض الأرواح, to seize the souls of the human being. We have ملك الموت, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him in charge to be collecting the souls of the human being. And he have also others, angels, who will assist him in taking the soul, shrouding the soul, taking the soul to the heaven, bring the soul back to the grave, all the things. But this part of their jobs also. And from their job, سؤال الميت في القبر, questioning of the deceased person after they put him in the grave. And when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us about سؤال منكر ونكير, they will come and ask him, من ربك, ما دينك, ما تقول في الرجل الذي بعث فيكم, and ماذا تعلمت وماذا عملت في علمك. They will ask every person that after they put him in the grave, four questions. They ask him, who is your Lord? And they ask him, what is your religion? And also they will ask him, what do you say about the man whom Allah has sent him? And what did you learn? And how did you act according to what did you learn? Every person will be questioned in the grave, and the two angels will come and sit the person and questioning him. Also, النزول بالوحي, also from their job or their obligation, their duties, that they do what? They come with the revelation, and most the revelation it had been carried by the angel Jibreel alayhi salam, with exception of there is a hadith one or two said about a malak had came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam with the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah. But 99% or 99.9% that the angel Jibreel is the one who is in charge of the revelation. We believe in the angels of Allah, and we believe in all the articles of belief, and one of them in believing in the angels, and believing in the angels is a must. Denying the angels of Allah knowingly, after the evidence, the verse has been shown to the person, it will take the person to kufr. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from all the acts and the saying of kufr. Ameen. Thank you for watching. We'll continue with other segment later on, inshallah. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك, عند الله knows best.